Hello and welcome to Inside Indiana Business. I'm Gary Dick. Well, construction crews are busy in and around downtown Evansville on millions of dollars in new projects. From the second phase of a cutting-edge downtown medical center to a new Hyatt Place hotel to new life for the tallest building between Indianapolis and Nashville, not to mention some health and life sciences projects in the region as well. There is a buzz in Evansville in southwest Indiana, and here now to tell us about it, I'm pleased to be joined by Evansville Mayor Lloyd Winnecke. And Mayor, it's always great to have you in studio.
Thanks, Gary. Good to see you.
As I mentioned, a lot going on. Let's get right to it. One of the big announcements in the region and really for the state as well, Toyota last week closing out what will be a $2.3 billion investment, 550 jobs. That part of a bigger story in the region.
Toyota is a big driver of the economic engine for all of southwest Indiana. 7,000 employees, literally over $5 billion in investment since opening in 1996. It's a huge part of why southwest Indiana is buzzing the way it is.
Well, let's talk specifically your city, Evansville, and downtown. A lot of attention, and you and others have been very intentional about investment downtown. One of the projects, the Stone Family Center for the Health Sciences, which has been open about a year now, going into its second year. Talk about the impact that that has had downtown.
So to be clear, this is an expansion of the IU Medical School campus presence in downtown, and it's a collaborative educational effort between IU, the University of Evansville, and the University of Southern Indiana. So you have graduate and undergraduate students learning health care in one setting. The IU School of Dentistry has its fourth-year residency program there, so there's a 14-seat dental clinic there. The anticipation of that opening, and now the second building on that campus, which will open this spring, has meant more than 60 new businesses have opened around downtown, in and around downtown, from restaurants to bars to shops to interior design studios. It's really been a big driver of our resurgence downtown.
And that second phase, Deaconess, putting a health center there. And how about the vibrancy, living downtown? Because I know that was a piece of what was anticipated.
Yeah, my wife and I, Carol, live right downtown. We live at 3rd and Main. And so it's very common now to come home from an evening out and see loads and loads of people downtown. You know, 10 years ago, that might not have been a case, but people could be in town for or downtown for a concert, a basketball game, a hockey game. They may just be coming downtown for a great dinner at a locally owned restaurant.
Convention business, hotels, hotel space, hotel rooms, long been wanted in downtown Evansville, and it was a long time coming. But now you have the DoubleTree Hotel, which is open, the Hyatt Place Hotel, about to open. What has that meant, or what impact has that had on the convention business, in particular your sports niche?
Yes, our sports tourism has grown very nicely. We've been able to do what Indianapolis has done on a smaller scale, and we've carved out a really good area for ourselves. We're the host, we're in the second year of a four-year commitment from the NCAA to host the Division II Elite Eight basketball tournament. That's a big deal for us. We've been able to attract the Ohio Valley Conference men's and women's basketball tournament that had been previously in Nashville, Tennessee for 2.5 decades. We're in our third year there. So the additional hotel capacity has really helped us expand our sports tourism, and that's a big driver of why we're successful too.
Technology and innovation are part of the downtown development too, specifically the post house. Talk about what that is, because it's really about future living, futuristic living, if you will, and one of your regional cities projects.
Well, I may get some pushback from my colleagues around Indiana, but I think this is arguably the best regional cities project in Indiana. The whole idea behind regional cities was to drive investment in our regional cities to draw millennials and improve quality of place. This is a joint venture between Vectren, now CenterPoint Company, and General Electric. Vectren wants to test new sources of residential energy, and GE wants to test the efficiency of their smart appliances. So you'll have real-time connectivity between those two. Think a living lab, if you will. So 144 market-rate apartment units downtown, underground parking for 150 cars, really dynamic green space that will be open to the entire community, right next to where Brewburger is. So it's a really dynamic project for Evansville. Architecturally, it's unique for downtown also.
Very quickly, we only have 15 seconds, Mayor, but the old National Tower, which has been vacant for a long time, has been acquired. What's the potential there? Tallest building between Indianapolis and Nashville,
right? Tallest building in a 130-mile square radius, purchased by the Domo Group. very confident that it will be one of the big mixed-use developments, 60-plus apartments with retail and shops. That's an 18 to 24-month timeline, but we're very confident that will be a very successful project as well.
Very good. Evansville Mayor Lloyd Winnecke, obviously a lot going on in Southwest Indiana. We appreciate you coming by. We'll talk to you soon.
Thanks, Gary.